7. If you want to try and 18th, and our benefit concert on November 24th. For more information and other things happening, check out the insert in your bulletin.
Stand together for our call to worship. For I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord."
We will rejoice and be glad in you, and be glad.
this table, they wanted me to join this and this place. As we prepare to partake in God's blessed presence in mind as well as by just not being preoccupied by the business of our lives, but fully present here with God at God's table. Let's stand together as we communion.
invited to the banquet to tell them to come, but they refused to come. Then he sent some more servants and said, "Tell those who have been invited that I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fattened cattle have been butchered and everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet." But they paid no attention and went off, one to his field, another to his business. The rest seized his servants and mistreated them, sent his army and destroyed and killed him. The king was enraged. He sent his army and destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, "The wedding banquet is ready, but those I invited did not deserve to come. Go to the street corners and invite to the banquet anyone you find." So the servants went out to the streets and gathered all the people they could find, both good and bad, and the wedding hall was full of guests. But when the king came in to see the guests, he noticed a man there who was not wearing wedding clothes. "Friend," he asked, "how did you get here without wedding clothes?" The man was speechless. Then the king told the attendants, "Tie him hand and foot and throw him outside into the darkness, where he will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many were invited, but few were chosen."
Yes, you do. saints.
That wine at weddings sure does taste good.
Well, I wouldn't have to stop so many grapes if y'all didn't drink so much.
And Brina, how many times do I have to remind you that Jezebel is my second cousin once removed?
Well, I don't care.
Well, I know.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Yeah. seated for just a moment.
Hallelujah.
A few weeks ago, Indy Bradford made a profession of faith and was baptized at church in Charlotte, North Carolina. Indy has grown up here with us, and we are going to be celebrating him along with all of our children, Hannah Showalter and Madeline Showalter, for the work that they've done. But I thought it was important that we take a moment to recognize Indy's profession of faith and his baptism. So let's celebrate. And after Indy gives our benediction, we'll all head down to the kitchen area where we will have a reception to celebrate so much. Remember, don't say no to the banquet.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen.